Hello, everybody. Welcome back. So now we talk about the web server from the murrelektronik switch. In the first time, we go to the Siemens Proneta tool. And here we can see the, I will say, test case of the product. And in this time, we go to one of the switches. And we press the right button and open the web server. So when we open the web server, we have the chance to go on the right side to English. We change to English. And then we say, okay, the username is admin and password is private. So after then we log in and we come on the first side of switch. On the left side, you can see the device name, and this time 3M5TXPN IP67. You see the device description, and on the right side here, you can see the device information from the order number, the serial number, hardware version, and so on. On the left side, you have here the connection for the IP address, for the subnet mask and the gateway. And on the right side, you can see the lock. When we go to the top, we have here the topics, information, Profinet, device configuration, ports, network, software, and lock. And after the topics, you have got here general, neighborhood, and ARP table. So now we change to the neighborhood. And here in neighborhood, you can see all the ports, port 1, 2, 4, and 5. And you can see, okay, which device is connected to him and which IP addresses. After that, we go to Profinet. And here you have the chance to download the GSTML file for the Profinet switch. Under that, you can see the device name. And you see that the RA connection is connected because we have a connection to the PLC. And you can see the controller ID. On the right side, you can see the MRP informations, but in this case, we have no MRP. After that, we go to the device configuration, and here you can see the system description. Yeah, and this time you have the chance to write down here a device name, device description, a contact, or the location where it is built. After then, we go to the IP configuration. Here we have got the chance to change the IP address, the subnet mask, or the gateway. By the manage configuration, here we have got the chance on the left side to save the current configuration of the switch. So when you change something, you have after then the chance to save it. And after that, when you need it on another switch, you have the chance to go directly here to bring it as a transfer. After that, we would like to go to the ports. And then we will look about the port table. The port table shows you all the 5 ports of the switch. And you can see here by port state that all the ports are activated. When you say, okay, what port? I don't need it. We have the chance to say deactivate. And then nobody can connect to this port and go directly to the switch. For the port link state, you have to see every port is actually working with 100 megabit full duplex. And by the port mode, you have the chance to say, okay, I would like to work every time with 100 megabit or with 10 megabit or with auto negotiation. By the port link SNMP monitoring, you have the chance to activate or to deactivate what you need. The next point is statistics. Here you can see, okay, from each port, how many packets are going, broadcast, or you can see all the fragments, the collisions, all of them. By the port mirroring, here you have the chance to say one port is a mirroring port, to go for a diagnostic with Wireshark to the switch to check is everything okay in my network. On the port network, here we have the RSTP configuration for you and the SNMP. Here you can say, okay, I would like to deactivate or disable the SNMP protocol versions or the SNMP traps or something else. Yeah, the point software. Here we have got one topic, the installation. By the installation, we have the chance to make an update from murrelektronik. Here you can download it from the murrelektronik online shop and go directly here and install or make the installation from your PC. By the plugin overview, you have to see all points who are actually activated. In this time, NTP, SSH server, and the web server. And one point, the OpenVPN client is deactivated. You have the chance to activate it when you click here. And the rest, or the last point, is the log server. Here we have the chance to see the last 20 entries from, in this time, the switch. And here you have got the last point with the settings where you can say, okay, I would like to give out this destination IP address. So I say thank you, and I hope it was enjoyed for you. We see us in the next video.